Dear students, in previous classes we can come across the factors influencing retailing. So in this session we will observe some more related concept called international retailing. So what do you mean by international retailing, and what are the benefits of international retailing, what are the challenges that we can see later. So usually retailing means that we know it's a process of providing wide variety of choices or services to the consumers ultimately. That is what we consider as retailing, from the various quantities, like small quantities however they want, or else breaking up the bulk, providing the goods and services in the required quantities, even from a small to large. That is what we consider as retailing, what we consider as breaking of bulk. So what is international retailing? Whether the retailing had us very heavy, we should think about, we should go back to the classes. So you can come across retailing, scope of retailing, I'll not bother why retailing is very very important nowadays. So entire thing depends on retailing. So when we have that much scope of retailing, we should have and think much more view why international retailing will not happen. That's what we have to study this year. So international retailing, when you have a very wide scope of any one concept, obviously it goes behind the borders. So even international retailing is not a new concept to us. We have come across many kinds of international retailers like Walmart, Gap, Samsung, Panasonic. So all these what we consider as international markets. So what you can come across, everything is nothing but globalization. So entire world considers single market for the production purpose. So when you are in that much, when you are in process of that much competition levels, obviously when you are providing, when your retailing activities should be in a international mode. That is what we consider as international retailing. So all the activities involved in selling the products and services to final international consumers for their personal consumers. Otherwise you can go with your own meanings. So anything, it's a process of providing various kinds of quantities of goods and services to the international consumers over the borders. So other than that, now international retailers anta helbodu. So ee tara international retailing start agutte. So international retailing, the main basis for starting international retailing because of globalization, only the globalization in development of MNC companies, more cross border transactions, more reliability between the friendly in the countries. So they have a lot of perspective. Even though the ultimate aim of any business is to provide reaching of best quality of goods and services at any point of level to the customers, that is what we consider as international retailing. And we can see some of the challenges faced by the global retailers. So what are difficulties? So international business, now anuge helbodu doing business in over the borders or doing business in more than 2-3 countries anta. So when you're doing is, when you want to do that, you have to come up the various problems. So that are, what are the challenges, what are the roles that you are going to overcome before starting up the international business. So first point is coping up with the technology. So technology nowadays, that we know, technology means not only computers, even you can take the machineries, production level technology, distribution level technology, and distribution level technology, the kind of vehicle that you use, the kind mode of transport, everything. So when you're dealing with my major thing is how you are going to adopt the uniform technology compared to other competitive firms or companies. So that is what we consider the first point, coping up with the technology. Whether what is the existing technology we have, we can use the same kind of technology in our business, with the help of that business, how it is going to impact. So like the terminal conditions that we should see, that is what are changing the technology. And today we have this much of technology, after 5 years technology changes, so suddenly we cannot replace everything. Again, it needs a huge capital. So it is how you are going to do that on that time, etc. Then language barriers and varying communication styles. So language barriers, that we know, English is the common language, what we think, But most some countries should not prefer English. They prefer their own language, their own language. Like example, China, Japan, Tokyo. They want everything. They support for in common language, but they should try to get the things on their own language very very convenient way. So the way the communication styles, so everything, it will be again biggest difficult. For example, the product mode moving from India, so even you can able to understand what is the product or service, what you are going to deliver to your customer. So again, language is the biggest barrier. We come to know we have more than 200 plus countries. That time 200 plus countries, we have 200 plus languages. So if you found that English is the common language, after behind the English also we had to face a lot of problems while communicating what is exactly happening to the customers. Then consumer empowerment. So consumer empowerment here refers to, it's a process of how good the customer is, how the customer able to understand, how the customer able to get knowledge about your goods and services. Example, take India only. In India only, many kinds of customers should not know, we should not get the proper knowledge about what they're using regular products or services. So we're creating the customer knowledge, creating customer awareness and making customer unities, it's not a very small deal. So the consumer empowerment is so easy. You know, when we are dealing with international marketing, international business, sometimes customer want to know some basic rules and regulations of your international business, tax procedures, etc. So consumer empowerment is more important. Before the consumer empowerment, you have to give knowledge about how to deal with the activities. Then cultural complexities. So cultural conflict is one of the biggest factors. So here we can see our Indian culture is completely different. You observe Madi, Western culture or some of the Southern culture, it's again completely different. Vice versa, opposite tara irutade. So on the time neev yav tara handle martira, neev international business madbekandre ibbargu same product kodtivi andre people won't accept. They want the product or service according to their convenient. Here they want the product according to their convenient. So it's one of the biggest dramatical changes madbekaga the product services alli. So again, it impacts on production levels. The customer satisfaction levels kadame aagabodu yargadru obrige. So it's a very very complicated process how you are going to convey their cultural activities, because customs traditions, what they believe from their ancestors, that they count, that they continue throughout the year, throughout the life. So on that time, it's a precious way how do you overcome all these problems and stand up with your products or services. The international shipping policies, it's again about the how you are going to move goods services from your international borders in the seas, ships, what are legal procedures, what are the tax formats, what are the tax acts, how much you are going to pay, how much, what is the import duties, etc. So all these policies, what is the balance of trade, how the government supports to you people. So all these points have to take care of. Sometimes it will be a little burden. The price will be more 100 rupees, tax will be again 100 rupees sometimes. So you should know all these policies, then you have to take a step towards the international business.